हेलो दोस्तों, वेलकम टू लिखो स्टेनो एकेडमी। दोस्तों, आज मैं आपको ट्रांसक्रिप्शन नंबर 16 की डिक्टेशन दे रहा हूँ, जैसे कि हम डेली करते हैं, तीन अलग अलग स्पीड पे, 70, 85 एंड 105 वर्ड पर मिनट। दोस्तों, आप चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करने के लिए अपने फ्रेंड्स में शेयर कर सकते हैं, ताकि ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा सबकी हेल्प हो। और जैसा हमारा मोटिव है कि जो क्लासेस नहीं ले सकते हैं उनकी भी हेल्प हो सके इससे। पहले मैं डिक्टेशन आपको दे रहा हूँ 70 वर्ड पर मिनट पर, सो बी रेडी फॉर इट। द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन दैट आई वुड लाइक टू डील विथ इज द पैराग्राफ इन द प्रेसिडेंट्स एड्रेस रिलेटिंग टू द प्रोग्रेस मेड इन आवर इकोनमी, इन आवर एग्रीकल्चरल सेक्टर, in our industrial sector, in our foreign trade, etc. Sir, you were pleased to read out to us a very large list of the achievements of the Congress government during the last decade and the important targets which have been achieved during the last 10 years of our planned economy. You also mentioned the question of increase in production, increase in the production of agricultural commodities, etc. Fortunately, sir, here we have in our midst the ex-deputy chairman of the planning commission, Shri V.T. Krishnamachari, who has addressed a number of meetings and seminars in New Delhi recently, drawing our attention to the weakness in our agricultural sector. If the press reports are correct, in one seminar he mentioned that even if all the targets of the 10th 5-year plan are achieved, still at the end of the 10th 5-year plan period, we may be facing a serious situation regarding the supply of agricultural commodities. He has also expressed the hope that we will be able to exceed the targets which have been fixed for the 10th 5-year plan. I do not know whether his expectation of exceeding the targets will be fulfilled or not, but it is quite clear that we have not been able to give sufficient attention to the development of the agricultural sector. It has also been stated that development of the agricultural sector is one of the most difficult tasks which have been found difficult both by democratic countries as well as by countries in which total planning is going on. It is all the more reason, therefore, that we should pay more attention to the agricultural sector so that it may be possible for us to meet our requirements as and when they arise एंड द सिचुएशन विच ही हैज फोरसीन एट द एंड ऑफ द 10th 5-year प्लान मे नॉट मटीरियलाइज. इट इज नो यूज मेयरली टेकिंग रेफ्यूज बिहाइंड सम ऑफ द फिगर्स विच हैव बीन compiled and narrating the progress which has already been achieved. We are happy that some progress has been achieved, but we are anxious that more progress should be there, and for that purpose also certain definite steps will be taken. In this connection, I am also happy to hear what the Defense Minister said yesterday in one of his public meetings, namely that the Government of India is contemplating to create a setup in our villages wherein our panchayats will be functioning more or less on the lines of parliament. Unfortunately, he did not elaborate that point further, and the press has not thrown any more light on what that exactly means. But if it means that the panchayats will be in charge of the resources that are available in the villages, that they will be in a position to determine how best the productive efforts in the villages are to be directed and in what direction, determine what targets are to be achieved and when the production is there and there is a surplus to be exchanged with other centers in the country, that the panchayats will have their say in the matter on what terms this surplus will be exchanged with other centers in the country, then I think a very valuable step forward in the direction of building our economy on a decentralized basis will have been taken. We have always taken the view, sir, that if planning is to succeed in our country, and if there is not going to be any regimentation of our productive activity and forces, what is necessary is that the common man should have a voice in determining the economic policies and in formulating the economic plans of development, and should have also his say in determining on what terms a village or a group or an industry should be working for the development of economy as a whole. In other words, some amount of competition, some amount of bargaining power is to be generated in the lowest strata of our society and in the lowest rung of our economy so that with the help of that bargaining power under the overall influence and policy of the Planning Commission, it may be possible for us to develop our economy in a manner which satisfies both the interests and the requirements of the nation as well as the aspirations of the people. When people feel that they also have their say in the formulation of policies and programs, and that such policies and programs are not something which is dictated from New Delhi, but are those which have been worked out. So, दोस्तों ये थी 70 word per minute per dictation, और अब मैं आपको दूंगा dictation 85 word per minute per. So, be ready for that. The next question that I would like to deal with is the paragraph in the President's address relating to the progress made in our economy, in our agricultural sector, in our industrial sector, in our foreign trade, etc. Sir, you were pleased to read out to us a very large list of the achievements of the Congress government during the last decade and the important targets which have been achieved during the last 10 years of our planned economy. You also mentioned the question of increase in food production, increase in the production of agricultural commodities, etc. Fortunately, sir, here we have in our midst the ex-deputy chairman of the Planning Commission, Shri V. T. Krishnamachari, who has addressed a number of meetings and seminars in New Delhi recently, drawing our attention to the weakness in our agricultural sector. If the press reports are correct, in one seminar he mentioned that even if all the targets of the 10th five-year plan are achieved, still at the end of the 10th five-year plan period, we may be facing a serious situation regarding the supply of agricultural commodities. He has also expressed the hope that we will be able to exceed the targets which have been fixed for the 10th five-year plan. I do not know whether his expectation of exceeding the targets will be fulfilled or not, but it is quite clear that we have not been able to give sufficient attention to the development of the agricultural sector. It has also been stated that development of the agricultural sector is one of the most difficult tasks which have been found difficult both by democratic countries as well as by countries in which total planning is going on. It is all the more reason, therefore, that we should pay more attention to the agricultural sector so that it may be possible for us to meet our requirements as and when they arise and the situation which he has foreseen at the end of the 10th 5-year plan may not materialize. It is no use merely taking refuge behind some of the figures which have been compiled and narrating the progress which has already been achieved. We are happy that some progress has been achieved, but we are anxious that more progress should be there, and for that purpose also certain definite steps will be taken. In this connection, I am also happy to hear what the Defense Minister said yesterday in one of his public meetings, namely that the Government of India is contemplating to create a setup in our villages wherein our panchayats will be functioning more or less on the lines of Parliament. Unfortunately, he did not elaborate that point further, and the press has not shown any more light on what that exactly means. But if it means that the panchayats will be in charge of the resources that are available in the villages, that they will be in a position to determine how best the productive efforts in the villages are to be directed and in what direction, determine what targets are to be achieved and when the production is there and there is a surplus to be exchanged with other centers in the country, that the panchayats will have their say in the matter on what terms this surplus will be exchanged with other centers in the country, then I think a very valuable step forward in the direction of building our economy on a decentralized basis will have been taken. We have always taken the view, sir, that if planning is to succeed in our country, and if there is not going to be any regimentation of our productive activity and forces, what is necessary is that the common man should have a voice in determining the economic policies and in formulating the economic plans of development, and should have also his say in determining on what terms a village or a group or an industry should be working for the development of economy as a whole. In other words, some amount of competition, some amount of bargaining power is to be generated in the lowest strata of our society and in the lowest rung of our economy, so that with the help of that bargaining power, under the overall influence and policy of the Planning Commission, it may be possible for us to develop our economy in a manner which satisfies both the interests and the requirements of the nation as well as the aspirations of the people. When people feel that they also have their say in the formulation of policies and programs, and that such policies and programs are not something which is dictated from New Delhi, but are those which have been worked out. दोस्तों 85 वर्ड पर मिनट की डिक्टेशन थी और अब आज की फाइनल डिक्टेशन आपको देने वाला हूँ 105 वर्ड पर मिनट पर, सो बी रेडी फॉर दैट. द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन दैट आई वुड लाइक टू डील विथ इज द पैराग्राफ इन द प्रेसिडेंट्स एड्रेस रिलेटिंग टू द प्रोग्रेस मेड इन आवर इकोनमी, इन आवर एग्रीकल्चरल सेक्टर, इन आवर इंडस्ट्रियल सेक्टर, in our foreign trade, etc. Sir, you were pleased to read out to us a very large list of the achievements of the Congress government during the last decade and the important targets which have been achieved during the last 10 years of our planned economy. You also mentioned the question of increase in food production, increase in the production of agricultural commodities, etc. Fortunately, sir, here we have in our midst the ex-deputy chairman of the Planning Commission, Shri V.T. Krishnamachari, who has addressed a number of meetings and seminars in New Delhi recently, drawing our attention to the weakness in our agricultural sector. If the press reports are correct, in one seminar he mentioned that even if all the targets of the 10th five-year plan are achieved, still at the end of the 10th five-year plan period, we may be facing a serious situation regarding the supply of agricultural commodities. He has also expressed the hope that we will be able to exceed the targets which have been fixed for the 10th five-year plan. I do not know whether his expectation of exceeding the targets will be fulfilled or not, but it is quite clear that we have not been able to give sufficient attention to the development of the agricultural sector. It has also been stated that development of the agricultural sector is one of the most difficult tasks which have been found difficult both by democratic countries as well as by countries in which total planning is going on. It is all the more reason that therefore that we should pay more attention to the agricultural sector so that it may be possible for us to meet our requirements as and when they arise, and the situation which he has foreseen at the end of the 10th five-year plan may not materialize. It is no use merely taking refuge behind some of the figures which have been compiled and narrating the progress which has already been achieved. We are happy that some progress has been achieved, but we are anxious that more progress should be there, and for that purpose also certain definite steps will be taken. In this connection, I am also happy to hear what the Defence Minister said yesterday in one of his public meetings, namely that the Government of India is contemplating to create a setup in our villages wherein our panchayats will be functioning more or less on the lines of parliament. Unfortunately, he did not elaborate that point further, and the press has not thrown any more light on what that exactly means. But if it means that the panchayats will be in charge of the resources that are available in the villages, that they will be in a position to determine how best the productive efforts in the villages are to be directed and in what direction, determine what targets are to be achieved, and when the production is there and there is a surplus to be exchanged with other centers in the country, that the panchayats will have their say in the matter on what terms this surplus will be exchanged with other centers in the country, then I think a very valuable step forward in the direction of building our economy on a decentralized basis will have been taken. We have always taken the view, sir, that if planning is to succeed in our country, and if there is not going to be any regimentation of our productive activity and forces, what is necessary is that the common man should have a voice in determining the economic policies and in formulating the economic plans of development, and should have also his say in determining on what terms a village or a group or an industry should be working for the development of economy as a whole. In other words, some amount of competition, some amount of bargaining power is to be generated in the lowest strata of our society and in the lowest rung of our economy, so that with the help of that bargaining power, under the overall influence and policy of the Planning Commission, it may be possible for us to develop our economy in a manner which satisfies both the interests and the requirements of the nation as well as the aspirations of the people. When people feel that they also have their say in the formulation of policies and programs, and that such policies and programs are not something which is dictated from New Delhi, but are those which have been worked out. तो दोस्तों ये थी आज की तीनों डिक्टेशन. अब मैं आपसे मुलाकात करूँगा ट्रांसक्रिप्शन नंबर 17 के साथ कल, और आई होप आप सभी लोगों ने अच्छे से इसे लिखा होगा. दोस्तों फिर से रिपीट कर रहा हूँ कि रीडिंग पे बहुत फोकस करें, रीडिंग बहुत ज़्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है. जितनी ज़्यादा आप रीडिंग करेंगे, जितने अच्छे से आप रीड करेंगे, उतने चांसेस आपके सिलेक्शन के बढ़ जाएंगे, क्योंकि एक्यूरेसी आपकी उतनी अच्छी होगी. भले ही आपकी टाइपिंग स्पीड कम हो, लेकिन अगर आपकी रीडिंग स्पीड अच्छी है तो आप जो वहाँ पे पढ़ेंगे एग्जैक्टली वो जल्द से जल्दी टाइप कर पाएंगे. सो अगर आपकी टाइपिंग स्पीड, मैं फिर से कहूँगा, 20 वर्ड पर मिनट भी है, तो आपको चिंता करने की कोई ज़रूरत नहीं है. अपना शांति से दिन का एक मैटर ट्रांसक्राइब ज़रूर करें, आपकी टाइपिंग स्पीड भी बढ़ जाएगी धीरे धीरे, ट्रांसक्रिप्शन ट्रांसक्राइब करने की स्पीड भी बढ़ जाएगी और एक्यूरेसी भी आपकी बढ़ जाएगी. मिस्टेक्स निकालने का जो तरीका मैंने पहले बताया हुआ है, शायद वीडियो नंबर 3 या 4 में, उसको ज़रूर फॉलो करें, क्योंकि वो एक ऐसा फॉर्मूला है कि आप घर पे ही अपनी इजीली मिस्टेक्स फाइंड आउट कर सकते हैं और एक्यूरेसी के चांसेस बहुत ज़्यादा बढ़ जाएंगे. दोस्तों सिलेक्शन उसी का होता है जो ध्यान इस चीज़ पे दे कि मुझे क्या नहीं करना, क्या करना है ये तो दुनिया को पता है, क्या चीज़ मुझे नहीं करनी जिसकी वजह से मेरी सिलेक्शन में प्रॉब्लम हो सकती है. अगर आपको वो चीज़ पता चल जाए तो आपका सिलेक्शन 100% होगा. सो एनी वर्ड्स के साथ मैं आपसे अलविदा चाहूँगा, और कल मैं आपसे मुलाकात करता हूँ ट्रांसक्रिप्शन नंबर 17 के साथ. तब तक के लिए अच्छे से लिखिए. ऑल द वेरी बेस्ट. बाय बाय.